Thank you. The heck? The hell are you? Hey folks, welcome back to After Work Gaming. Tonight we're back in Syndrome. And what we have to do, let's just double check real quick. Restart the engine, find access card in the medical bay, and then find a tool in a storage room in order to get to the medical bay. What we need to do is we need to get to 5, storage room, right above us. We have to hook around, so we have to go this way. Of course, superheated steam is not our friend. Alright, we hear it. We got you. Whoa. That's the guy, I guess, who was standing outside the room where we came from. Creepy creep over there. And it would be cruel and unusual for them to throw something at us while we're unarmed. Or... oh, well. You know, cruel and unusual though it may be, I'm seeing a lot of, like, distractibles, right? Like, we can pick this up and probably toss it somewhere to make noise. Good. Because that means... that basically means they can throw anything at us at any time. Okay, here we go. Sean T. Alton used to make fun of me. He won't laugh anymore. Not without his tongue. Okay. Alright, Sean. It's good to know. Not creep about. Okay. Spooky.
Who could have done this?
Shit! Kalen, do you know the concept of sneaking or being in a place with zombies? Don't ask questions. Okay, so that's where we would have to go. Can we get into this computer core? Just, oh no, it's locked. And then what else? Let's see real quick over here. I know, like, a zombie was running around, but I'm fairly confident that I can outrun it. It is a stumbling, bumbling... okay, that's not gonna... fine. This is a lot of dead bodies, and this is more... more the kind of pace that I would have expected people hanging themselves. This is more ritualistic. Oddly enough, more ritualistic hangings require thicker ropes, which I don't think is right. God, you don't toggle crouch. You just, like, have to hold down C. This is the computer core. Computer core? No, this is the, I'm sorry, this is the storage room. Okay, the code. You have the code? Well, you don't have a leg. That's not helpful to me. Nothing useful. Well, bury my life. Here we go. Daniels S. I don't know what's going on with all these new security protocols. Everyone's going nuts here, and I have the feeling they're not telling us everything. We should just wake up everyone from cryosleep. I received a new access code for the storage room, 56197. I can't forget this again or the boss will kill me. Wow, log entry 321 of 2893. Yeah. May 14th, 2189. Interestingly enough, this has a different date format than the others. Oh, and check it out, top right, 56197. Storage room. Good. 56197. I'm gonna assume that he died when whatever collapsed the ceiling went off.
Access granted.
Thank you. Tip, check closets and some crates for objects like batteries, ammo clips, and health kits. Huh. Are there crates here? Kind of hard to see because it's all flashing red. Okay. Kantos, I, 7 of 12. See, now I don't know anymore. April 1st, 2189. Let's just stick with the European format. It seems the company accepts anyone inside their ships nowadays. I remember when the selection process was so demanding that barely anyone got in. Now we have all sorts of punks in the crew, even ex-convicts. Okay. Am I one of said punks, Kantos? Be nice to know. Okay. Still nothing. Red light is distracting, though. Okay. So this is the storage room. Oh! Cool. Lockers. Okay, nothing. Yeah. Door. Relax. No? Ooh. Batteries. I'm hoping that means we're gonna get a flashlight soon, but... I mean, your guess is as good as mine.
I can use this for defense.
You can attack, and you can block. Well, I'm gonna guess that the game is about to open up from here, because now that we have a weapon, or something that can at least help us defend ourselves, I don't know how well, there's nothing holding the game back now, right? There's nothing... Okay. There's nothing that's gonna stop the game from just throwing stuff at us. Which is concerning. Kantos, I had my suspicions about illegal drug dealings in the ship, but now I'm sure. The technical crew is all involved, I know it. I'm going to take this to Summers. Kantos, just watch out, alright, man? Because, you know, nobody likes a narc. And more importantly, snitches get stitches. You know what I'm saying? Okay, that's not a crate. Alright, well, I got a weapon now. I'm feeling marginally more safe up until I, you know, see the first enemy. And then I'll feel marginally not safe at all. And by marginally, I mean completely not safe at all. Okay, alright, okay, I hear ya. Nice. Why don't we try... What if we look around the other way? Right? Whoa.
These voices are probably the effects of cryosleep.
You know what? I love it that you think that. But you forgot the nervous laugh. These voices, they're just cryosleep. I mean, it just so happens that this entire ship freaks out around me and yells, you know, you can't forget. It's nothing. Seriously, Kalen. You need to, like, wisen up, man. Let's just be vigilant, alright? We're not gonna creep around. I'm not looking to creep around here, but let's just be... Okay, there's a robot on fire. Nice. Easy. Alright, let's go just quickly check out... There's a server storage. You see number two? We're gonna walk down this corridor real quick. It looks like a live wire down there. This thing right here, we're going to avoid it, because I suspect that we would hurt ourselves, and I'm not in the mood to hurt myself here. Okay. So, you in the server storage room, and then we're going to get the heck out of here and go back to 5, because at least on doors. Oh, I see. See, there's like a vent shaft between that room and the navigation systems area. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so let's go back to 5. We now have the tool to open up that vent so we can continue on past the... I was going to say the barricade, but it really just looks like debris. Okay, but for that, I go down here. We're going to sidestep the wire. Good. Ish. Place is picking me up, though. Alright, that thing's on fire. It's no problem. A little on fire, but I do want to see what's on that body. Cool. You look terrible, man. Nothing useful. Fine. Oh boy. This isn't foreboding at all, guys. I have to say, I don't play a lot of, like, atmospheric, creepy... Ooh, I found some food. Atmospheric and creepy explorer maps, but I am liking this so far. Door locked. Come on. Let's just take a quick run. Nope. Let's not take a quick run. These are red barrels. If they follow Doom logic. Oh, proximity. Not good. Also, I don't see the... Whatever. I don't know if it follows Doom logic. Let's just run through. Okay, there's more wires. Sidestep the wires. Let's not... Oh, hold on. Take a quick swing. Ooh, it eats stamina. Okay. Okay, well, I don't know why I blocking does not... Well, maybe blocking while getting hit will eat stamina. Okay. All right, easy, guys. Can I go up there? That's like a catwalk up there. That's pretty cool. Ish. Okay. Ropes. God, it's the ropes. Ah! God. Sorry about that. I'm an idiot. Let's see. Use. Oh, cool. The food does help me heal. That was an unforced error. I'm sorry, guys. That's on me. That's what happens when I walk and talk. Okay, well. Take this nice and slow. Come on. There we go. So, as I was saying, though, taking a swing with this tool, which looks like, you know, the more serious... No, we're going to save when we get the 5. The more serious brother to, like, Gordon Freeman's crowbar here. That thing. Right. We're here. Would it give me any guff? Okay. When we take a swing of this thing, it eats our stamina, which is not great. It's not ideal. Okay, just... Let's just make it to the elevator, eh? Okay, sprint to the elevator now. Thank you, and 5, 5, 5, 5, 5. Okay. I guess I'll see you guys after this loading screen in case it takes too long. Hey guys, we're back on 5. Just me, or is something missing here? Used to be a big robot here, I believe. Okay, let's save this game before it gets any further. Because I'm assuming, like I said, that they're going to start throwing stuff at us. Let's rotate saves as per usual. Okay, now. Let's see where the map takes us. Alright, so we need to get back to 3. That's the chemistry lab, so right up and a little bit to the left. So that we can get through that vent to 4, the physics lab, and then... Oops. Sorry, my guy was like freaking out while we had the map up. It was kind of weird. Okay. Now, technically, we've already been here, but... Of course, as every good survival horror slash explore 'em up game, okay, no, we'll tell you, we'll show you, you can never really be too safe, or never feel too safe in an area you already explored, because frankly, they'll just put stuff there, right? Because those shuffling zombies are just shuffling around and will eventually get here. Okay, let's. Open this up real quick. Like that. I can't get over it. Like, it's really cool. The design in this place is really well done, I think. Okay. Where are we now? 4. Physics lab. Okay. Well, there's Al over there. Some sort of strange apparatus. Weird. My head is exploding. Every damn noise makes an echo inside my brain. I can't even think anymore. Even that hurts. April 1st. Okay. Let's see where we are now. Now, we're gonna... Before we press on to 10, which is medical, which is all the way at the top of the map, we're just gonna basically duck into any room we can find. Because at this point, it's become clear that we need to start hoarding supplies. And there's a save point. That's good. Let's hoard some supplies, or let's get some supplies, and then... You know. Okay. Pistol locker? Yes, it is. Pistol clip. A pistol clip? Do you have a pistol? No. But you are missing a leg and a head. Nice. You have anything for me? No. Kind of callous at that. Like, at this point, I'm just over it, right? Like, oh yeah, dead bodies. No, let's just loot them. I've just devolved into just the regular process. Cool. Healing kit. Cool. Okay. Anything down here? No. Ah! I've got a foot. And I've got an arm. Useful, I think. Is it gonna be like, you know, I gotta use that arm to, like, scan in somewhere? What can I do? I have two extra rooms on that side. Let's go check those out before I do anything else. Not labeled sensor station and nav systems. Nav deck systems, okay. Can't get to that guy. Dead robot. Let's go check out these rooms before I save. Not that we're gonna save scum or anything, we're just gonna... wanna make sure. Okay, so food. Okay, so this is like, we can come here to hide. Ah! A Broken Man by Solis Jeanlin. Kill, 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 okay. I don't know what the what was written on the burned off area, but I'm assuming it said kill. Okay, go down here. This is a depressing area to work in. Holy moly. Down here, nothing. Not even a chair. Oof. Okay. Bowden T. All April 1st, 2189. The access code for the medical bay changed again. It's now 11154. I hope this new code lasts more than one day. It's interesting. Oh, it's because everyone's like freaking out about security, isn't it? It's, I guess maybe it started with people stealing stuff from the storage area over there that we couldn't get into. No, we're not gonna go there yet. Another, man, there are a lot of like mechs here. Nope. Search all of these lockers. We've become looters now, but, you know, what are you gonna do? First of all, I'm apparently assigned to this ship, so I should be able to do that, and I... ugh. But I can't get in there, and those just look like... I'm gonna go with... it kinda looks like numbers backwards, okay. Can I hide in these lockers? Is that possible? No. This is just purely, like, empty lockers all over the place. I'm kinda doing anything. For now. Okay, let's go quickly save the game, right? Because then we'll press on to the med bay. And let's guess, rotate. Remember, rotating saves, because I don't care how feature complete, how finished, how AAA, how well respected the studio, whatever. You know, bugs are bugs, and you never want to lose your game. And especially in these kind of games where seeing things for the first time is important. You know, having to backtrack and, like, run through an area or an experience or, like, I don't know, a jump scare, right? We had a couple thus far that you've already seen just kind of loses out on something. Okay, you guys can stop with that atmospheric stuff, eh? Doctor? He had some food on him. Don't have food on you, Doctor. It's not sanitary. Okay, this is, like, a little storage area. Ooh. Health thing? I don't want to call it a health thing. A health kit. Right. Looks like an EpiPen. Which I'm assuming in the future is still cheaper than what they're costing now. Ooh, topical humor. Anyway. Or topical reference. Not really that funny, is it? Attention center. Can't get into. Why? This is kind of dark, right? Detention center is right next to the medical bay. On the one hand, I'd like to think it's because the doctors go in and tend to the guys who are in detention center, but on the other hand, what if they experiment on the detention center folks? Okay, let's check out the system real quick. Dr. Robert Vobach, medical. Message 1. Robert, I understand your concerns, but you have no reason to worry. This is a veteran and experienced crew. What they need is some R&R time, and they'll have it when we reach our destination. We're just carrying an extra piece of cargo, and the company has assured me that there will be a bonus for everyone for making the small detour. Eric, I'm worried about the crew. Every day I get more people coming in with headaches and unable to sleep. Men and women with no history of violence getting into fights. Trouble focusing. I tell you, it started when the soldiers brought that thing aboard. I'm starting to fear for our own safety. Okay. Trey. Maybe this is just an email for, like, everyone on this in this little complex, the medical and detention. Trey, one of our patients attacked Nurse Sarah today. The patient was homicidal and completely oblivious to his surroundings. Luckily, Sam from the warehouse was in the medical bay, and he was able to help us control the situation. Barely. And Sam's a huge man. We need to have permanent security here. We can't go on like this. Nelly, or Neely. I heard about what happened. Trust me, I would put someone there on guard duty if I had enough personnel, but we're already stretched thin. You know how things are in the ship? I'll have someone check on your guys later today, okay? That's really the best I can do for now. ID, Aegon. Aegon, J, Security Chief. Aegon is a decorated ex-soldier of the United Colonies Army. Wow, it's a little fuzzy, so it's a little hard to read. Sorry, guys. Of the Colonies Army. As a veteran of the Cerberi campaign, Aegon was involved in some of the most intense battles during the Martian occupation. Despite my continuous efforts, he refuses to talk about what happened here. There was one single time when he opened up and told me about the Jakara incident. He was leading a squad that shot down a troop transport during the liberation of the space city. When he reached the crash site, there were bodies burning everywhere, some still alive. The transport was carrying fresh recruits, kids, according to Aegon. 94 men died on that crash, mostly consumed by the flames. Aegon was awarded the Star of Valor. It's easy to understand that he's a very troubled man. He says he joined the Pioneer Fleet looking for peace. I recommended keeping up for regular psychological checkups. Oh, so they got a psych aboard. Okay. Morton, S, AI Specialist. Dr. Morton is a brilliant technician with vast experience on robotics and AI. He's been with the company for 11 years now, always involved in the most advanced projects and missions. The request for transfer to the Heyerdahl, I guess this is the ship. No, this isn't the Heyerdahl. Is it? Sorry. The request for the transfer to the Heyerdahl came after the incident aboard the Jupiter station. The details are, parens, not strangely, scarce, but from what I've heard, the team was testing highly aggressive AIs, some project for the military. But something happened there, and three people ended up dead, supposedly killed by his droids. Morton is introvert and suspicious of everyone. I detect a slight case of paranoia, possibly drug use. I recommend keeping him up for regular psychological checkups. Kyle J., shuttle pilot. Kyle is a former fighter pilot of the Mars Defense Force. He joined the Pioneer Fleet after completing the mandatory time in the armed forces in his own words, quote, more coin, less trouble. Although Kyle's an adept pilot, he also manifests reckless and imprudent behavior, especially when in the cockpit. Adding to this, there are also reports of gambling and fighting with other crew members. I recommend keeping him up for regular psychological checkups. Cool. Found out a little bit about the crew. Not surprising, people come out on these long-haul trips to get away from stuff. What that? Doesn't look good. 1-1-1-5-4.
Access granted.
Thank you. The heck? The hell are you? Okay, that's, not like, it's basically just a husk, right? I mean, seriously, just a husk. He's kind of being held together by nothing, and there's just nothing but metal inside, or it looks like there's nothing but metal inside. She does not look that good. Yeah. I mean, she couldn't have died that long ago, but this is not... What the hell happened? Okay. Log. Weir. 7 of 12. April 1st, 2189. It was all in my head. Got a bit better after I cut my nose and ears. But I only got well after I took out my eyes. And I even see better now than I ever used to. That Weir? Because, I'm assuming he's not the only one that looks like that. Okay. We just have to look around. Whoa. Okay, let's just take a quick cheeky peek around. Anything in here? No. Shush. Hot dog. Okay. More logs. Robert V. Oh, so the Robert Vobach. This is the doctor. Veskin was brought in today, missing four fingers. The techs who brought him in say he deliberately stuck his hand inside a vent and just stood there smiling as it crushed his fingers. He was still smiling as I was tending to him, but what really got to me was his eyes. I swear there was a moment when they looked all black. I know this isn't possible, and then it's probably fatigue playing tricks on me, but it really creeped me out. Again, April 1st. Okay, so April 1st seems to be when stuff starts going down, like, for real. Okay, let's go take a look down here. Uh-huh. Okay, what do we have? What do we have? We got another doctor who's dead. I'm assuming Vobach is dead. I'm assuming probably Vobach is the guy in the, like, the vestibule area. Oh, it's not an actual active computer. Okay, that's no problem. That's no problem. Can we open this? Can. There's nothing there. That's fine. Can we hide in these? Hold on. Important to know which ones we can hide in. Yes, we can hide in these. Cool. And by cool, I mean terrifying that we can hide in anything and that this game requires us to hide in things. Another door over here. A medical saw? Why do we need a medical saw? Concerning me, but that's fine. Okay. Okay, so there's nothing else in here. Let's just go down the hall and go check out the rest of the two rooms. Because we need a key card, right? Let's just double check. An access card, yes. Okay, well, at least it's... the pain. I hear you, man. And there it is. Let's not pick it up yet. Maybe this is Vobach. I don't know. Could be. Nothing useful here. Nova Core. No, let's just check the lockers real quick. Nope, nothing. Painkillers hide the pain. They don't cure it. True. The pain. Wave after wave. Restart the engine. Well, that's going to wait until the next episode. Let's just finish looking at this and then get to a save point before, you know, something eats our face. Because the longer it goes without something jumping out at me, the more likely it is that it will. Although, wouldn't it be awesome if this was just a game of, like, nothing but tension? Where they never actually attack you, they just continuously scare you? Probably not going to happen here, though. Jan D. April 1st, 7 of 12. Had a talk with David, and he agreed with me. Everyone's losing their shit, and things are not going to get better. There were several murders yesterday, and no one is in jail. No one seems to care anymore. We're getting out of here in an escape pod. Yeah, Jan. Hopefully, I guess. We can cure it, we can grow it, yeah. Wow. That is one... Wisdom teeth not erupted. One tooth missing. That thing ever grows in, that would be terrible. Look at those teeth. Holy moly. Someone had a really, really bad teeth. Man, throwing it out there. Okay. That's medical. Okay, that was a thing that happened then. So I'll just relax. I've got my crowbar, my space crowbar. Let's just get to the save point, eh? Easy. Easy does it. Shh. Oh my god, I got spooked by the door! Alright, we're gonna save. Okay, so, as we're saving, next time we're gonna go restart the engine. We are then going to probably have to start... I mean, I don't know. I'm assuming at some point we're actually gonna have to start, like, avoiding things actively, rather than just being scared of our own shadows. So, if you enjoyed this episode, like, comment, subscribe. Lets me know that you, you want to see more of it, and that I'm doing something right. If you guys think I'm missing something, if you'd like to see something else, if you have complaints or thoughts or constructive criticism, by all means... leave a comment, everything's welcome, and in any case, I'll see you all next time.